The spinal column can be divided in the following segments: cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacrum, and coccyx. Spinal disorders can occur in any of these elements. The intervertebral discs act as shock absorbers for the spine. The spinal column undergoes degeneration with age. Sometimes these discs can degenerate, thin, or herniate. When this occurs, pressure from the two vertebrae coming in contact with each other can compress the nerve and the spine, resulting in back pain. In severe cases, repair of this disorder requires spinal fusion. Many patients with back pain, leg pain, or weakness of the lower extremity muscles are diagnosed with herniated disc. When disc herniation occurs, spinal disc is pushed outside its normal position, diminishing the space for the nerves. This spinal nerve compression can lead to spinal stenosis, where it involves more than one disc to prolapse. The surgical treatment of herniated disc in the lumbar region is called microlumbar discectomy. In this process, the surgeon makes an incision over the center of the back. He then uses the interlaminal space to access the prolapsed disc microscopically and relieve the spinal nerve compression. Once it is removed, the spinal nerve gets decompressed into its normal state, giving relief to the patient. Spinal fusion is a surgical technique in which one or more vertebrae of the spine are united or fused together so that motion no longer occurs between them. This procedure involves removal of the damaged disc and replacing it with peak cage. The cage is inserted where the disc has been removed. Finally, to provide stabilization, small pedicle screws are inserted for steady healing and long-term fusion.